luck with pole vault stuff. I swear.
She's like the best, so it's okay.
I know.
Thank you. Good.
Excited for tomorrow?
Yeah.
Did Coach VP talk to you?
Yeah.
Nice. Also, the most insane, like, pole vault, like, fail.
Thank you. Stay tall, be patient.
Do you want to pause, coach?
Watching the weather. Windstar is our bus company, and as far as I know, well, the plan is they'll be here Saturday morning to make sure we get loaded up and we take off. We'll watch the road, step, we won't do anything stupid, okay? We'll make sure things run smooth. So the plan is we'll go ahead and head down there Saturday morning as scheduled. Okay? If you haven't checked out Blackboard, the meet lineup, please make sure you do that. I've got a hard copy here too. You can look at that, make sure you know when you're supposed to be and where you're supposed to be at those times. All right, Raiders. I'm looking forward to meeting and just kind of seeing where we're at. So we'll do. Dr. Parker has graciously offered to do a devotion for us today, so please give him your undivided attention today, Raiders.
Good afternoon. Blessing to be here. I'm going to talk to you this afternoon about the word submission. Most of the time when athletes hear that word, they think it's like four-letter word. I don't submit to anybody, right? Well, I learned about biblical submission from my wife 24 years ago, and it made such an impact on my life that I remembered it. So I'm driving with my wife now, around a 6-hour drive to meet her parents in Colorado. 6-hour drive, about half an hour into the drive, we're engaged, and I'm going to meet her parents and stuff. I'm engaged to her, and she asked me about a half an hour into the drive, Micah, what do you think about biblical submission? Do I have to submit to you as your wife? So I'm thinking to myself, don't answer this question. This is probably a trap. There's nothing positive that's going to come out of this. You have no idea what you're talking about, Micah. So don't say anything. So I changed the topic. I changed it quickly. About an hour later, she asked me the same question. I'm pretty good at diverting her, so I diverted her again. And about another hour, now we're about halfway through. I'm thinking, 6-hour trip, halfway through, she's asked me, how am I going to possibly keep her at bay for another 3 hours? She could tell that I was very uncomfortable because she kept on asking me the question. I didn't have a good answer. I was even starting to sweat a little bit down my cheek. She even mocked me for that. She could tell that I was stressed about that question. And then she said, Micah, relax. See, I want to tell you what that means to me. I believe God's word tells me that I need to, and this is the definition of submission that she gave for me that I've never forgotten. She said, I need to allow you to serve me. I am going to allow you to serve me. Wow. That's an amazing definition. So we've been married for 23 years. When I was an ignorant young man, and I read in Ephesians, wives, submit yourselves to your husbands as to the Lord. I was kind of an idiot, and I thought, oh, that means I get to tell my wife what to do when I get married. Is that how it is, Scott? Tim? No? That's not what it means. My wife's definition is really a great biblical definition to that word. A few verses later in Ephesians, it says, Christ love the church? That means I need to submit to my wife by saying, I love you so much that I would be willing to die for you. That's what that means. So when I said the word submission initially to you, that I was going to talk to you about that, most people, again, there's a negative connotation to it. If you don't understand submission, you're going to have a hard time being successful in life at all. Because whether you realize it or not, you submit to lots of things. You submit to many, many different people. Think of right now in your life, who you allow to serve you. You allow your coaches, okay, Scott, Tim. You allow your coaches to serve you, don't you? What about your faculty? What about your RA? What about your parents? The police. There's lots of different people that you choose to allow to serve you. Not only people, but things. What do you allow to serve you? I'll use some extremes here. But if you've chosen, I'm going to allow alcohol to serve me. I'm going to allow marijuana to serve me. I'm going to allow pornography to serve me. Well, there'll be consequences for those behaviors. It's not only who you allow to serve you, it's what you allow to serve you. So what does God's Word say about this? A couple other Bible verses I want to share with you. James 4:7 says, submit to God, humble yourself before the Lord, and he will lift you up. In Isaiah 64:8 it says, we are the clay, you are the potter. We are all the work of your hand. John 13, verses 12 through 17. When he finished washing their feet, he said, do you understand what I have done for you? I have set an example that you should do as I have done for you. Now that you know these things, you will be blessed if you do them. So those groups of people that I mentioned before, in the future, you're going to have to submit to a boss. And we can go on and on and on about all the different things that you are going to need to submit to in life. But those things are all important. But if you don't understand who to submit to with your spiritual life, that's even more important. Because failure in this life is important, but failure in eternal life is really, really important. God's Word says that we are to submit to His Son, Jesus Christ. And when we acknowledge Him as our Lord and Savior, we will be given not only eternal life, but I think on our time here on earth, we will be given a different type of life, the type of life that serves others. So I want to pray for you. Before I pray, though, I want to mention that there is one group of people that you should never, ever, ever submit to. Ever submit to. And that's who you're about to run. Can we all agree on that? All right. Let's bow our heads and pray. Heavenly Father, I thank you so much for these young men and women here on our team. I thank you for calling them to Northwestern. I thank you that they're here. Lord, I ask that you bless their season. I ask that you bless them with wise choices on who they submit their lives to, who and what they submit their lives to, who they allow to serve them. In Jesus' name we pray this.
Hey, before we get into a big circle, I wanted to introduce Megan Van Garden. She's from Jordan, Minnesota, a vaulter, a senior vaulter. She's checking out vault practice today. So if you get a chance sometime after the workout, please say hi to Megan. We're glad to have her here. So let's get Megan around. Well, let's go ahead and circle up, Raiders. Let's go down to courts 1 and 2, Raiders. Let Bob finish up here. Got it.
Out. today?
No.
Okay.
Yeah. If you do not let go of the pole.
Right, I'm
not. If you don't let go of the pole.
Your subscriber's gonna be like, who is he yelling at?
Who is it?
Who is he?
Get off.